Last time I read it, I wrote a poem that was inspired by an episode of NPR's On Being, and this time I'm going to do that too. I'm thinking I'm starting a series here. So it's a great show. All night I dream of prisons. Bless the cloud that blessed the sun and hid it from my anger, my red face, and the sometimes broad and often pressed so tight that nothing can squeeze through container of my mind, love exists. So too, there are flashes of a red so pure, it is my only access to a first red, an ether red, Plato's red, Plath's red headband, torn from her head by hues at the party where, in my head, they meet again. It's a beautiful, dim-lit place, and sometimes jazz plays, a riot of forms gone wrong. I don't even know, for Christ's sake, what a cornet sounds like, or when Ornette Coleman lived or played and maybe died. Bursts of red, the flap of a red-winged blackbird, the upright strike of a proud salvia. Sylvia goes where salvia grows, wherever I go. The same God that has never called me to sing of him might even now be calling me to sing of what I think is godlessness, but is instead a crack of light. Sweetie pie, there's a little fetching keyhole in this day, reminding you of the severance you strike between yourself, that bundled hive, and the day is another lie, another method of survival that will kill you in the end. Look in or out. There is a red so vast, each red thing is a falling off, a fat vat of jewels to run the sun through, an empty chalice dunked and filled with derivations of this swell, nameless in its light. It's light. I swear, I sing of this, or I am silent. Thank you.